Hello guys, what you doing? So many items, my God. Well, let's start off with Raisin's girl picture. Sign. So glad you came in. Everyone here is such a loser, but seem pretty really cool. Lexus. All right. This comes from the episode entitled Raisins, of course. And this started off as an episode in which Wendy dumped Stan for reasons. I don't know what reasons, but eh. And then they came out with, what do guys do when a friend gets dumped? Well, they take him to Hooters to cheer him up, and they. And they thought up an alternative to Hooters for kids, and that was Raisins. But anyway, so Stan gets dumped, and then he gets all depressed like, and gets in his room, and listens to old 80s songs about love and such like Cinderella and which was it? Air Supply, which which Trey and Matt have said that, yeah, because we were from the 80s, we put Stan to listen to this because a little kid in the 2000s wouldn't listen to Air Supply or Cinderella, which yeah, no, I was kind of listening to those because I had a CD with oldies and I kind of liked them. I mean, what's wrong with them? But yeah, of course he tries some things to get Wendy to unbreak to unbreak with him. First he sends Jimmy, of course, to tell her that he loves her and that she's his continuous source of inspiration. And then Jimmy, of course, you know what Jimmy's thing is. He kind of babbles, and Jimmy goes up to her and says, "Stan thinks you're a cunt. Stan thinks you're a cunt. Cunt, cunt, cunt." Yeah, well, he's an asshole, and she leaves, and then he says, "Continuous source of inspiration." I think they actually said that this was the second time they got away with saying cunt on the TV show, The first one w was actually back in something you do with your finger, which I didn't talk about. There was a part in which Wendy was auditioned to be the fifth member of the boy band, and she did this little song, which of course is like it's that thing which you sing to verses, and then the last word of the last verse is kind of a naughty word, but then instead of the last word, you make the last word part of the first word of the next verse. So, for example, because she's a contaminated water, I don't know exactly what that trick is, but that's what she used. And here they kind of get away with saying cunt because Jimmy is kind of babbling. And then of course it makes things even worse. And then Stan kind of goes in front of Wendy's house and of course lifts a boombox and plays some tunes. But then he discovers that . He discovers that Wendy's new boyfriend is Stoken, and he gets even more depressed. And Kyle comes in and says, "You know, dude, you're moping around so much. You may as well go and hang out with the goth kids." And that was supposed to be, a line, a joke. But then they kind of say, "You know what? That would be cool. Let's create the goth kids," and that's what they did. They created those four goth kids, which are great. And I touched upon them in my in my previous video when I talked about each of them individually. So he goes to the goth kids. They're like, "Yeah, life is pain. We are nonconformists. You have to be a nonconformist to join us, and you have to be a nonconformist, but you have to conform with us," which is kind of hypocritical, but what can you do? So of course, Stan becomes the fifth goth kid and starts, smoking and drinking coffee and writing poetry about sadness and death and shit like that. And that, of course, came from Trent Matt's experiences in high school, because they say that in America, in each American high school, you have kind of these groups, which haven't changed much from then. You have the jocks, you have the cheerleaders, you have the geeks, but you also have the goths, and of course, goths still exist nowadays, but unfortunately for them, they are confused with either vampire kids or emos or shit like that, which kind of bums them out, dude. Emos, vampire kids, and goths are fucking, different from each other, and goth kids are by far the most awesome. At least in terms of music. So yeah, Stan becomes okay, and in the second story, of course, the guys take Stan before he becomes emo. They take him to Raisins, which is this Hooters kind of place for young kids, and there, they try to make him feel better, but Butters thinks that the Raisin girl is serious, Lexus, and kind of falls in love with her. And then he like, it's sort of great. It's he goes through the same arc that a guy who would fall in love with a stripper would go. He brings her presents. He invites her somewhere after hour, but she says, "No, sweetie, come on, come to Raisins. You only can see me there." And then yeah, she gets out of work and sees Butters, and then the bodyguard comes between them. And yeah, Butters is stoked that he can speak with her. And then in the end, his parents tell him that girl is just after your money, and you should break up with her. And then Butters kind of, starts crying and such. And then Stan and the goth kids come and try to get him to join them. But then Butters says that, "Yeah, it hurts, but this pain makes me human, and I'm gonna live with it, and I'm going to get over it. For now, I'm sad, but I'm going to get better, you know." And then he just calls the goth kids fags, and that kind of wakes up Stan, and Stan becomes normal again. Not that goth kids aren't normal, but normal for them. So that's it. Randy's DUI record includes a charge for cleaning the vomit off the breathalyzer. Well, this comes from the episode Bloody Mary, which was the season finale of season, I mean, the finale of season 9. There's supposed to be kind of a Christmas episode, sort of, and in it, it's another Randy story, of course. And the gist of it is that Randy is a drunk. He goes to to pick the kids up from karate. Okay, and of course while waiting he has a few and then kind of gets in the car and drives them and on the way he still gets a few beers. It's kind of a commentary on a few tens of years back, like 20, 30 years, people, drank a beer or two before going out, driving. And it wasn't such a big deal, I mean, their commentary on this whole driving and drinking thing is that, driving a little driving drunk is bad, but driving a little buzz is okay. You're following the speed limit. You're not doing anything crappy. You're just you're not being lame. And they actually remember that people way back when they had a 200, 200 or 300 mile journey, they actually took a six pack with them, and enjoy the road. Because, for fuck's sake, most of America is just straight roads. You don't have any curbs. So, for example, on a straight fucking road in the middle of nowhere, I think you could drink a beer and just go because you can't hit anything. There's nothing to hit. But anyway, legally, I must tell you guys that I am against drinking and driving. I don't even have a driver's license and yet don't have a driver's license yet, and so I don't. But what the fuck am I saying? Back to the episode. So of course, Randy kind of empties a bottle and then pees in it. Because apparently that's what people do. That's why you have a penis. So sorry, ladies, this is something only a man can do. If you don't have a shiwi, which is if you don't know what a shiwi is, then don't Google it. It's not funny. Okay, so of course the police kind of pull him over, and he is he's forced to go to AA meetings, Alcoholics Anonymous, and they talk about how the AA is a cult because the AA have this whole philosophy that you don't have the power to change yourself. Only God has the power to change yourself, which is, come on, dude, you just need some restraint, that's all. And so AA teaches people that they are powerless, which is kind of a wrong lesson. And you have to throw away your worry. I mean, throw away any thought that you will be able to get better on your own. And just admit to God that you are bad and ask for to make you better. And this also ties in with the retarded concept that alcoholism is a disease, which it just isn't. Alcoholism isn't a disease. It's a dependence, just like being on crack. It's not a disease, it's a choice. You put that fucking beverage in your mouth. The fact that you don't have any self-restraint is not a disease, it's a mental fucking condition. Not a mental condition, but lack of restraint is kind of shitty, and but you can work on it. I am not making a good point now, aren't I? Back to the episode. So of course, Randy kind of admits that he's powerless, and goes home and cuts off all of his hair like he has cancer or something, and just drinks beer after beer. And then they hear the news of a Virgin Mary statue, which apparently started bleeding out of her asshole. And they say that it's a miracle, and then Randy goes there, and the Virgin Mary statue kind of shits blood on his face. And there's this whole great scene where Pope Benedict kind of, I mean, Pope. Anyway, the last Pope, the previous Pope, goes there, and the statue kind of shits blood all over his face. Which Trey and Matt jokingly say that, Anne Garofino, our producer or something, told us to do it. It was her idea, and they kind of rip on Anne Garofino a lot because she's Catholic, and whenever they have kind of a Catholic episode, they say that it was all her idea, which I don't think it was, but anyway. So the statue shits blood on Randy's face, and then he's cured. But then they, but then they actually find out that the Virgin Mary statue wasn't bleeding out of her ass, but out of her vagina. And they say that a chick bleeding out of her vagina is no miracle at all, so it's not a miracle, and so you are not cured. And then Randy kind of collapses and starts drinking again, but then Stan says that, that statue wasn't a miracle, so you gave up drinking all by yourself, and so that's all that you need, some discipline. And there's also a little part at the beginning with Cartman and the karate teacher, where the karate teacher says that you wreck discipline. And of course, at the end, Stan kind of gives this lesson to Rennie, so it all kind of comes together nicely at the end. Okay, let's do these two, because I don't think there were in any episode. Reach for the Skylar CD. This is from the Timmy episode, and I talked about it a few parts back. Rectal for doc photography kit. Even aliens need hobbies. I think that is it for today. So until next time, see ya. Bye.